Today, I'm going to be talking about one of my favorite ways to apply audio effects across an entire track, no matter how many times you cut it. Let's get into it. Internet, what's going down? Robert Teegarden back again with another Teegarden quick tip tutorial. Today, we're talking about applying track effects across your entire audio track. This thing comes in handy a ton when you have dialogue and you have things that are going on for a pretty long period of time, and or you've chopped up that dialogue and you have different sections across your entire timeline. And instead of copying, pasting effects over and over and over and over again, you get to apply a track level effect. But because there's a bunch of track level effects, you want to be able to copy and paste them across multiple tracks. You can always get into situations where you just simply copy and paste audio effects from one region to another, and that works totally fine. But it tends to be a pain in the ass when you start to do that across multiple sequences or multiple audio tracks. So in situations like this, what I like to do is actually apply effects across the entire track. And there's a very specific way that I've learned how to do this and copy and paste those effects that I think is gonna save you a ton of time and energy. So I'm working on this project right now in Premiere. I was just about to do the same thing. I figured I'd flip on record, let you guys see exactly what I'm doing here so that it can save you some time. Let's jump on into Premiere and I'll show you exactly what I'm talking about. So right here, I have a simple sequence set up. It's going to be a dialogue between these two individuals. They're going to be talking and using the same exact microphone setup, but just different lav mics. So effectively, I can use very similar settings across my two dialogue tracks down here that have been brought in and just make sure that I keep those audio effects the same, but I'm gonna be applying them across 10 minutes worth of footage. And so rather than applying them in each individual section that I make an edit to, I'm going to do it on the track level so that you can see how these things function. So the first thing I'm gonna do is go into the audio interface here in Premiere. You guys are probably familiar with some version of this. A lot of times people are using this Essential Sounds workflow, which is fine, but it doesn't give me as much flexibility as I like to and the ability to use the plugins that I like. I have some third-party plugins that's from Splice that I like a lot, especially where it comes from noise cancellation and kind of cleaning up my audio. And so I can't use those same plugins there the way that I intend to. So what I use is this kind of audio track mixer view. That's actually not where I want to go into. If you see this tiny little right-facing arrow, show and hide effects sends, that's what I want to do. Now this actually takes me into an interface that is looking back in kind of my audio days where you can apply plugins across multiple tracks and then send them to certain buses. So if you've ever worked into Logic or in Pro Tools, this will be kind of a familiar interface for you. So what I want to do first thing is move this around and say this is my dialogue one, or name the track that it's going to be on, and just have a reference point for what that looks like. That way, if I ever expand this area down here, I know which track I'm applying it to. The other thing I was going to make sure that I put in my audio effects plugins that I use across the entire region, that entire track. So I always start with a single band compressor. Next thing I'm going to do is put in dynamics. I'm going to make sure that my EQ with my parametric equalizer is on point. And these are the third-party plugins that I end up going into. So I go to the Isotope Suite, the RX7. I always use spectral denoise, and then I'm usually going to put some type of de-esser to roll off the hard S's on the track that I'm going to be using. Now, this is a pretty consistent dialogue setup that I'm going to be using across multiple iterations, whether it's an in-person dialogue like this. Most of the time when you guys are hearing it, it's some form of this type of plugin setup as well. So then I can go in and start to populate the different settings that I want to use. I usually start with my voiceover setup, but that's not really what this video is about. This one's about how do I set this up, number one, and two, how do I copy the same exact track settings onto the secondary dialogue track that I have. Now this is actually pretty simple. It's taking me a little bit to get here, but what I go to is the top of this setting. Let me close out this little window right here. I'm gonna go to the top of this setting. I'm gonna right click, and you're going to see copy track effects. If I copy track effects and go over to my next dialogue, I can go in and say paste track effects, pretty simple. Paste those track effects, and now the same plugins that I applied on my track four are going to be applied to track three. Now, the one thing I will have to do every once in a while is to recalibrate some of the effects that I've used, especially the native Premiere effects, and kind of move them back and forth. And that's okay, because a lot of times one person will be hotter than the other, so they won't need as much compression, or their bass, the vocal EQ might be a little bit different, or presets might be a little bit different. So having to modify some of the plugins, the way that they sit from the first track I got, I don't really have a problem with that, but it's just going through that menu. I hate having the little drop down menus because my mouse always moves over and I end up missing it. So just copy and pasting those effects across the different dialogue tracks that I have. And even more importantly, if I have multiple sequences from the same setup, let's say I do multiple videos within that one day of recording and each topic has its own sequence that I set up, applying that track data across multiple sequences is a game changer. It saves me a ton of time. So again, this way, what I am able to do is copy track effects from one to the other, saves me a ton of time, and then I go back and tweak those effects depending on what that individual's dialogue sounded like, what that person sounds like, whether they're loud, they're soft, their EQ's different, all of those things. But this is a quick and effective way going in through the audio panel and working within this environment within the audio panel is a fast way for you to be able to copy effects and modulate them quickly and saving you a bunch of time in your bigger edits or your edits that have multiple dialogue tracks. With this one in the can, ladies and germs, this is Robert Teegarden with another Teegarden quick tip tutorial finished. If you like this video, I would love it if you consider subscribing to the channel. I post content on a weekly basis on filmmaking tips and the business of being a creative. So if this is something that you did, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, ring the bell for post notifications. I will see you guys in the next video. If you love this, give me a comment down below. And with that in mind, ladies and germs, this is Teegarden. I'm out of here. I don't have any more time to waste because I got to go back into this edit. Remember, I told you I was actually working and my 20 seconds of the end screen's up. So I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.